Do you have a TEFL interview coming up and you don't know how to prepare? Well, TEFL interviews are a little bit different than a regular interview, and that's what we want to talk to you about today at No Mud Bears. First, more often than not, a TEFL interview is going to be done online because you're not going to be in the same country that you're applying to. However, if you do happen to be one of those people who decided to go ahead of time, that's great, good on you, because then you can do an interview in person. And you're gonna need to listen to a few of these tips, but don't worry too much about this first part. Now, if you're an online interviewee, keep listening. First off, online interviews. Know the software beforehand so you don't look like a complete klutz when you don't know what you're doing first time using Skype. Know what you're gonna be using and also have an account for whatever system of messaging they use in that country. So for here in Taiwan, we use LINE and WhatsApp a lot, mostly LINE. So it's important for us to have gotten a LINE account before coming here and have it on our resume so they know ahead of time that they can communicate through us through their preferred method of communication. And also make a test call. Now, a test call might sound a bit trivial, but it's pretty important because it's going to tell you if you need an extra microphone, maybe. It's going to tell you, do you need to be wearing headphones during the interview, what your lighting is like, and all of that is super important. Pretend you're on stage the entire time. Don't keep a light back here behind you. Keep a light in front of you so it's on you. Have a light that shows like you're on the stage, you're in a movie. That's exactly what you want for the interview. Make yourself look the best you can. In terms of attire for an interview, dress business casually. I used to wear a tie when I was doing an interview, so I look nice and professional. Make sure to wear pants as well. It's important to wear pants, even though you're doing an online interview, wear pants. You're gonna maybe need to stand up and do a teaching demo for a part of the interview. In that case, you're gonna wanna have pants on, otherwise you're gonna completely embarrass yourself. Stand up straight and look directly at the camera, okay? Don't look at the screen, because for the interviewer, it's gonna look like you're looking off into the distance. Keep a very plain or simple background that accentuates you, okay? If you're wearing a green shirt, don't sit with a green background behind you. Now, point number two, TEFL interviews can be a little bit different. They're gonna ask you questions about why do you wanna teach in this country? What's so important about this place? Why do you like kids? All those questions are gonna be a bit different than what you usually expect from an interview. So I narrowed down TEFL questions into three categories. First, demographics. Now these are your basic run-of-the-mill, how old are you? What cities do you want to teach in? These are all ones you're going to get in pretty much any interview, okay? So you're going to be fine for those. Number two, teaching-related ones. Now these are usually scenario-based questions or ones that say, hey, if you the boy starts crying in the middle of the class, what are you gonna do? Okay, so have a few of those prepared. You can look up a list online, just Google teaching related questions and prepare a few of those just so you get a sense of what it's like to answer those questions and show them off to a friend and get them to practice those questions with you because those can be some of the hardest questions for these interviews. Because we're never asked those questions. So think about those things. Ask questions too. It's not a problem to ask and understand the situation for these scenario questions, so you have an idea of what you have to work with. Lastly, character questions. Character questions are especially important because one of the biggest things these schools are looking for are that you're a good person, that you're gonna be reliable, that you're gonna come to the school and be trustworthy and not going to leave 2 weeks into your contract because they invested time and resources into training you and to possibly flying you there, and you have to be able to live up to that. So show that you are able to travel, that you're comfortable adapting to a new culture, and that you are ready to commit to possibly a year-long contract in one place. And show that through these character questions, okay? They're gonna ask you, tell me a time you faced adversity before. And tell me about an experience that changed the way you thought, okay? And those are good ones to take from previous experiences, either school or work, and give an example and elaborate on that example to really show how you adapted and how you faced adversity and brag a little bit in there. That's okay. Now, one final point on questions is you are going to get asked questions about where do you want to teach and what type of school do you want to teach in. It's a good idea to sort of write up on a page your ideal situation, okay? Right, I want to teach a class of 20 students. I want to teach this age group. I want to teach in these cities. And have on another tab Google Maps open, so when they name off, yes, do you want to teach in Yilan, Hualien, Pingxi, and you don't know what those places are, you can just quickly Google and say, oh, okay, that looks like a cool place. What's it like? Throughout the interview, your interviewer is going to try to relay to you information about the country, about the places, so that you get a sense of the company and if it's trustworthy. And remember that you are interviewing them as much as they are interviewing you. This is a place you're possibly going to live and work for a year. So find a place that you're happy with and ask more questions about how much resources I have. What are the living situations like there? All right, so ask them those questions. Maybe you want to ask a question about, hey, can I talk to a foreign teacher living there and understand what it's like for them? So get those questions across, see if those are something that you'd be interested in, and eventually, after a few interviews, you're going to start accumulating a list of possible questions. I had about 15, 20 questions I'd ask. I didn't ask them all because oftentimes the interviewer would answer all of them. But at the end of the interview, ask five of those questions to keep the conversation going and show that you're really interested in it. So do a little research, figure out your own questions, figure out what's important to you so that you can ask exactly the questions you need to know for the interview. Third, there might be a teaching demo involved. Now don't get too scared because a teaching demo isn't too bad. And by this point, when you're applying to jobs, you've probably already done a TEFL course. And if you haven't, do check out our video up here on certification, which we did last week, and a little bit about our experience with TEFL courses. If you've done a TEFL course, you finish that course by doing a teaching demo. So for the actual interview, you might need to do a short 1 minute, 2 minute teaching demo. They might prescribe something for you to do, and then you just have to create a lesson plan around that. If not, do something simple. Don't do grammar. Don't do grammar. I'm gonna say it one more time. Don't do grammar. Do farm animals. Do basic numbers, okay? Do something that is easy and just do a quick 1 minute, 2 minute lesson plan from that. Have it written out just in case they need it, just in case they need you to go over something like that, and you have it ready to go. When you're done with the interview, finish it by asking what the timeline moving forward is going to be. And the next day, send them a thank you note saying, thank you for this interview. It was great meeting with you. I look forward to talking to you in the future and further communications. And if they said they're going to send you some information, say you've either looked it over if they've already sent it or remind them to send it to you. Your goal at the end of an interview is to keep the conversation going. And just like us at Nomad Bears, we want to keep the conversation going with you. So if you like the video, give us a like down below. Subscribe if you want to hear more TEFL tips and travel information. Otherwise, have a great day and have a great journey.